Welcome back, guys. I'm Truthman from Overclocking TV, and this is the Overclocking World Championship Las Vegas 2017. So today we are I already have our first semi-final. We are moving to the second semi-final, and this will be featuring Lucky Noob from Indonesia that finished first in the qualifier against Dogna Osier from Japan. And Dogna is actually one of the outsider in this field. He's completely an outsider. He's ranked 724th in the world. Last time I checked, that was that. So he's not even in the top 100, and he's here today competing in the Overclocking World Championship. And he's going against one of the most prominent overclocker, Lucky Noob. All right, so can we have a Lucky Noob and have the view on what's going on at the stage? So they will be doing the lucky draw of the benchmark. Seems like that's gonna be a bit tricky to hear the sound. This the All right, we just need a few minutes before the game will be starting. All right, we just need a few minutes to hear the judge. That's the beauty of life, you know. Sometimes you have to take care of everything. And we are here at the OC World Championship Las Vegas 2017. We will soon be able to hear the judge and his countdown on this on the beginning of this game.
Count down from five.
All right, Ligo, if we can hear you, so we are good to go whenever you
Okay,
want.
guys, 2D Mark 11 physics. Five, four, three, two, one, and off we go.
And this is it. We are now in this second semi-final of the HWBOT OC World Championship at Las Vegas 2017. So we're seeing Lucky Noob against Dogna. Wilzoid, I'm glad to
Yes.
have you in this match for the commentary. So, what are you expecting from that specific game between Lucky Noob and Dogna?
So, well, 3D Mark 11 physics is actually a much shorter benchmark than the Super Pi 16 million we had last time. So they'll sort of, there's sort of less pressure to get runs in because it runs faster. So we'll be seeing, hopefully seeing more scores. On the other hand, it is also a again this is a multi-core benchmark, so it runs as many cores as you can give it. And it also is pretty good on scaling with memory performance. So, it's a tough one. It's not necessarily the hottest running multi-core benchmark out there. It'll certainly run a few hundred megahertz higher than a lot of other multi-core benchmarks out there. But it is, it's a nice enough multi-core benchmark. So, it'll be an interesting match, in my opinion. And right now they're both just, pulling down the systems, setting up their BIOSes to make sure that they don't have to, well, basically to get their scores as fast as possible. It'll be interesting to see who gets the first score out, because last match, the second score was the winner, so hopefully we won't be seeing something like that. Hopefully we'll see a lot of back and forth. So, Lucky Noob is now seems to be aiming to boot all the way into the system, as he isn't mashing the Dell button desperately as the Gigabyte logo comes on. So he will be the first one to get into Windows, unless...
Indeed.
Yep, and it looks like he's going to be doing most of his...
Yeah, that's no problem.
He's checking something about the benchmark.
Top forward.
So Lucky Noob, I want to check that... Wait. I can't just
right.
Make sure the license key
yeah,
on the live.
The 3D mark. Unfortunately, we can't give away free 3D mark keys to all of you, so you'll have to not see his screen for a bit there while he puts that in. Isn't that kind of like not fair to force them to put the keys in when they're supposed to be running the benchmark?
Well, actually, they're supposed to have one of the rules
the
is that
fully set
they
up.
Need to make sure that everything is working as expected on their system. So
did they never run 3D Mark 11 until now?
that's gonna be his issue. I mean, his choice, right?
Yep. Well, Lucky Noob's already aiming for starting at 5 gigahertz, and he's loading up CPU-Z, probably just to verify that all of his overclocks are actually applying the way he expects them to. So let's see where he cranks up the V-core, and he's taking it very slow, 1.55 volts. I mean, you can run that on water cooling for short periods of time, and he's going for 5.6 gigahertz. So that's actually a pretty high core clock for a relatively low voltage. Then again, this is under LN2, so the CPU clocks better just because of the lower temperatures. So it'll be interesting to see if this actually finishes, because if we compare it to like what we saw in the last runs, everybody was running 1.7-ish volts and similar frequencies and crashing. So be interesting to see how this goes for Lucky Noob with that low voltage.
Lucky Noob, first score, 14,320.
Oh, yep, it managed to finish.
We are the first score!
And this is where Lucky Noob's like ages and ages of experience in 1v1s is starting to show up. He already has his first score, and now it's just going to be, score after score after score after score if everything is going as he wants it to be going. So, and it looks like he's going straight for 5.8 gigahertz now.
Because that's funny, they all start at 5 gigahertz, and they know that's like super, super safe. Because 5 gigahertz on DCPU, you can do that with the regular water cooling.
Yeah, even high-end air cooling can get away with it if you do a fan swap and D-lid. And so, yeah, Kaby Lake is great for overclocking, so starting at 5 gigahertz is not anything surprising. He's already going up to 5.8 gigahertz. He also raised the voltage to 1.65 volts. So it looks like Lucky Noob has his CPU pretty well figured out, and he's already getting another score right there.
14,608, Lucky Noob.
That's actually a rather small improvement in terms of overall points. Then again, he only went up by 300 megahertz.
But that's important to keep in mind that it's step by step. I mean, that is the key in these kind of matches. Like 30 minutes of matches step by step is very, very important there. I mean, that just depends
on the benchmark duration.
Well, because unless you start at 800 megahertz.
Well, this is a very fast benchmark. I would argue for something like the 2-minute, Super Prime 16 million, you would actually want it to crash on you more than you would want to finish the runs. Because if it's crashing, that's not going to be a fast run. Because, it crashed. Whereas if you keep getting, if you go step by step, you're unnecessarily wasting time on runs that aren't going to be your best. So, whereas this is a very short
14,
benchmark. So going step by step doesn't chew up huge amounts of time for you. And he has another score.
He's on its way. He will not stop anytime soon.
It's interesting to see that he hasn't actually done anything to the OS yet. Then again, I'm not sure how tweakable Windows 10 is for physics in 3D Mark. I know Windows 7 is actually significantly more high performance, but in a 1v1 competition, it's more about seeing, if they're both on the same OS, then it's a fair competition. So makes sense to have them both on Windows 10.
14,921 for Lucky Noob.
Still improving his score.
And we're also starting to see the effect of just rerunning 3DMark will often get you better scores. And he's tweaking the Encore now. Yeah, he's just going like a machine now. Score after score after score. It'll be interesting to see. And it looks like Dognar will be doing a run soon.
Oops, I don't want to see the key. So Lucky Noob, soon to have one another score.
It just doesn't stop.
15,034 for Lucky Noob again.
That's the first score above 15k, so that's getting good. I mean, he's summoning a lot of score. That's the beauty of having a quick benchmark as well.
Yeah, so he just blew through 1500. And the interesting thing is he blew through that 1500 with a cache Encore tweak. He didn't actually raise his core clock at all for that one. He had his core clock the same, and then he just raised the cache. So you can actually sort of see that the cache actually matters quite a bit for this benchmark here, because that was basically 100 points he got right there. And he's running again. Also, this time around, he seems to have crashed as he's pulling the pot up. Yep, he crashed.
Torching hard. Zorching, like some people like to say.
Yep. And he also disconnected AC power to get the whole system to basically discharge. Which can help on some motherboards that have, aren't completely fully worked out yet. Though that's actually a common issue for a lot of platforms. Well, it's where it's best to completely unpower the whole system, drain all the capacitors and everything, and then they have an easier time booting up just because they're sort of like more fresh in a way for the BIOS.
Now it's okay.
We do have Dognar that will submit his first score.
First score, Dognar Overclocker, 13,809.
So he's starting pretty starting pretty far behind, and that's a 5.5 gigahertz core clock. At least, is it?
Yeah, it was 5.5. For the same frequency, actually, Lucky Noob was. Lucky Noob at 5 gears, I had a higher score before.
Yep. Lucky Noob is definitely leading in efficiency. I wonder if there's a difference in their memory settings. It could also be the Encore. This benchmark, it's happy to, it'll benefit from pretty much anything you throw at it in terms of CPU performance. So better memory settings, better core clock, better Encore. It all helps here. Still at 5.5, and he's running a lot more voltage than Lucky Noob is. So he's already at 1.7 volts, and he's going for 5.7 gigahertz now.
That's crazy to see that. There's something wrong. They should have it's close to 14K, so that could have been... almost crashed. Almost. I'm so expecting to have a
blue screen. That might have been just the benchmark loading in. A lot of the 3D benchmarks are a little bit weird about when they start up. The like Unigine in Heaven occasionally this weird glitch on some systems where you just start the benchmark and it runs at like 3 FPS for the first second. 41.
So there you go, Dognar is above 14K, so that's a nice improvement. He finally made it.
I would really like to see his memory settings, because I think that's going to be the big difference between them. Because Lucky Noob is consistently scoring better clock for clock than him. Lucky Noob is back in the operating system, so he's going to start opening up that lead again.
That's okay, so Dognar is now catching up a little bit, bits by bits, up to Lucky Noob. But we don't know what is the exact settings that he's using.
260.
So... Dognar just got another score, and it's a nice improvement of about 100 points. And actually, we're sort of seeing that slow 100-point improvement from pretty much everyone in this matchup. I mean, Lucky Noob did have a big jump of like 300 points earlier on in the matchup, but after that, it was pretty steady 100 point gains. So 15, Dognar doesn't one, really four, have four. To speed Lucky up Noob. That much. And Lucky Noob just picked up another 100 points. So
14,339, Dognar.
So Dognar improving again. Less improvement point. Than he had. He's just improving 100 megahertz by 100 megahertz. Maybe that is a safe way for him to do. Maybe that's his, one of his tricks as well. Don't forget, he's an outsider here. He's a complete outsider. He's not part of the top 100. He's not part of the top 500. He's part of the top...
He's actually ranked above me. But that's not really much of an achievement.
15,286, Lucky Noob.
So...
14,487, Dognar.
So you can see they're benching like side by side, improving their score. Yes, Dognar is getting close.
Yeah, he only has to close in by another 800 points, and there's still 17 minutes left in this round. Of course, that's 800 points, assuming Lucky Noob doesn't actually improve his score any further.
Lucky Noob.
Which just happened. So
Lucky, let's have a quick look at Lucky Noob settings. He's at 6.5 GHz, 5.7 GHz for the on-core, 6.5 for the cores. He's at 1.85 volt. Of course, they're using liquid nitrogen. And we might have some information from Dognar when he will be launching the benchmark.
Yeah. So Lucky Noob is actually approaching the sort of limit of his system. 6.5 GHz is it's still not the highest that a KB Lake can do. We've seen KB Lakes doing full all-core benchmarks at 6.7, 6.8 gigahertz, but he's already at 1.85 volts, and that's not far from the limit of about, well, you can run 2 volts, but at that point you start risking, you know, the CPU not surviving the benchmark run, or not even surviving idling in Windows at that point. So,
Lucky Noob should
be slowing down.
Yeah, he's actually, he just eat up the pot. He just torched the port to restart the system and do it once again. So Dognar is having some precious time right now to maybe catch up on Lucky Noob. They're having like maybe like 700, 800 points difference now. That's something that can be taken. Maybe some of the memory settings, as you say, were not the same, but these slowly and surely improving the scores. See the new score.
So yeah, he's making good gains right now.
And we're at 6.2 gigahertz, man. That's crazy. I mean, these KB Lake CPUs, these Intel Core i7-7700K, are clocking like super easy.
Like, this is already the 6.2 gigahertz is pretty much like, you know, the upper limit of some Skylake CPUs out there. So.
So just by a new generation of optimizing the process in manufacturing the CPUs, we get so much more overclocking room for it. So that's great. I mean, that's great although for you guys. That's also great for you guys at home gaming on your PC, because that means you can have higher default settings when you're going to be gaming. So higher FPS and better CPU overall.
Especially for a lot of KB Lake is ideal for single-threaded performance, really, because it's four cores, and it clocks really, really high, and it has the highest IPC of any architecture out there right now. So, you know, if you get a 5 to 5.2, if you really push a KB Lake to 5, you can get a 5.2 gigahertz out of it on, like, say, water cooling, custom and with a D-lid and replace thermal paste, but you can actually do 5.2 gigahertz daily.
14,894.
And at that point, you know, you just have the most single-threaded performance available on the market. Full stop. There's nothing that has more single-threaded performance at that point.
Closing the gap.
And Lucky Noob was just playing with his memory settings, and he's loading up. No, he's making a profile. So,
that should be funny if they start like the overclockers start putting like funny names in their profile because they know that it is live. Like Dr. Wiz that did that at the World Championship where he was opening Notepad while benching and says, "Hey, mom." Like, okay. See the two guys on the stage, torching on one side and just waiting for the system to restart on the other side.
There's 13 minutes to go, and Dogna Osir only has 500 more points really to go to beat Lucky Noob. So that's he's managed to really close up that gap compared to the start of the match.
Lucky Noob.
Less than 1-3 minutes to go. Give you a warning again at 10.
So Lucky Noob seems to be having some issues with his system.
Mousepad. It's the mouse pad. It's not the mouse.
Of course, there's
accessories like for
mouse.
1,000 clicks per minute.
Is that a gaming mouse? Maybe it's the maybe they should be using that on the tabletop.
He has too high APM. He's trying to change too many settings too quickly, and the mouse can't keep up. That's actually a legit concern for like pro gamers. Never thought, you know, that would actually show up in overclocking, but I guess, you know.
I mean, that could show up
if you memorize your like your BIOS layout really, really well. I could totally see you basically like blazing through all the settings, you know, just like 100 clicks per minute, and just set up a whole BIOS in like a couple seconds, which, you know, would be kind of incredible and a really good advantage for these overclocking events. Of course, you'd also have to use like one motherboard pretty much exclusively in order to get that good at the BIOS, or at least one vendor only, since they, you know, each vendor has their like standardized BIOS layout. So
that's the thing as well. I mean, each of the vendors have their own way of doing the BIOS. Like here today, we're using Gigabyte motherboard, so Gigabyte and Aorus. These guys have their own way of doing the BIOS as well. I mean, you can use a framework or you can use your own stuff. So there's a lot of things going on. I mean, that's different. They can differentiate on some of the features when and depending on how the way they do their own BIOS. Sometimes it's good. Sometimes it's a bit more complex to deal with. But otherwise, that's always nice to know that all these people working in this industry are working towards making the hardware working for everyone. I mean, it's like the Kaby Lake CPUs. I mean, there's not a lot of new things on these CPUs because that's similar architecture than what we had before, that was called Skylake. But
15,363
in new score. And so what we see today is more like the improvement from the CPUs. Like, oh, okay, so now it's like an overclocker's dream back again. It's like there's no callback, so you can go with as many LN2 as you want, and you can just set the settings,
well,
and usually it works.
Well, Skylake already didn't have a cold bug. It just had thermal paste cracking issues. So when you actually loaded up all four cores, it would disconnect itself from your LN2 pod and crash. So, but Kaby Lake doesn't have that because it does have a larger die, which significantly helps with actually that issue. Because the biggest problem actually also it helps with just overall having a larger die gives you better thermal properties when overclocking, so it solves the thermal paste cracking issues. There's no cold bug again, which is great.
people love that. I
less
mean,
than 10 minutes,
right? Super fun. So we have 10 minutes left in this match. They're running Polymerc 11 physics.
And Lucky Noob just pull out a hell of a score, going 300 points up from, like, he was frozen for a bit at that 15,300 mark, and now he just jumped by almost 300 points. And, you know, he's not even pushing his highest clock so far. He's at 6.4 gigahertz, so. Although, admittedly, I think he crashed at that 6.5 gigahertz run, did he not?
I think he crashed it, yeah.
Yeah.
Can see. That's a matter of precision. Oh! Blue
Sheen! It's not a real one. It's a fake one.
There is no other. Well, the blue screen crashed. The system crashed so hard it turned blue, but couldn't even print out an error message. So that's
You're
still
the first
an achievement.
Today,
You're the first that's still today. Like that's like between that when you just black screen completely and get a blue screen. So yeah, blue screen so hard the blue screen froze.
Sorry guys for the users. Ah, finally, the first blue screen of this competition. That's great. Finally. I think people here at the venue were like, what the hell just happened?
They must not watch our stream.
Well, they are watching it here from the venue, but some people were like
Yeah, but they
discussing about the new
must have
product.
watched it in the past. I mean, it's like you watch the overclocking TV competitions, you expect to have blue screen yelled into your ears so loud that they start to bleed.
So this is
And
Dogna settings, adjusting the chip ratio. So
see,
let's try.
I actually don't know anything about Z270 BIOS on Gigabyte, so I actually shouldn't talk about how I would tweak it because it probably wouldn't work.
Well, you can always try.
Yeah, but it's like I have no idea what he's doing. I mean, I get the voltages, understand voltages, and
So memory voltages, multiplier, the ratio. Did he regular timings? No, enhanced.
I do believe the enhanced performance setting on the Gigabyte motherboards, that's not that new. I do believe my X99 board has that. And basically what that does is it help the motherboard will train the memory timings more aggressively, the sub timings. So like you have so he has the channel A standard timings, which he just changed to 18, 18, 18, 18. Well, under that you also have the advanced timings, and those are controlled by the motherboard. So setting the memory enhancement settings to enhanced performance, that'll lead to basically the motherboard setting more aggressive advanced timings in order to get you more performance, which can save you a lot of time if the BIOS of the motherboard is actually good. Because sometimes you will see really bad incompatibility between certain memory kits and certain motherboards, where if you try
Hello,
to
we need
run,
a chair. Otherwise, I move it
try
away.
to let the motherboard
Good.
do its own thing with the memory timing, it just won't even boot. So. But it
So
seems
yeah.
like if for the system it works. So otherwise I don't think he'd be
Not from Windows either.
trying to have fun.
Here we have in the center the judge, Mr. Lee Gooft, judging today. Usually it's a Christian Ney, but Christian Ney was not able to make it, so there is an interim judge, I would say.
Less
And
than 6, 540.
on the right side it's Dogna and Lucky Noob get the red spot. So they are both troubleshooting their systems. They are either heating up or restarting the system to go into the BIOS. So let's have a quick focus on what is Dogna doing in the voltage. Action voltage
He's a
1.8.
Is he having trouble applying? Okay, 1.2. Can he not get it to set above 1.3? Oh.
Might be.
Because he tried to punch in 1.35 and it basically took and it just defaults to auto. Well,
It
bad.
still does need it does need like a good 800 megahertz to 800 points to pass by in front of Lucky Noob and maybe access the final. So, but keep in mind, like, Lucky Noob is very well trained. I mean, he's actually training a lot of other people in Indonesia. He's part of the Jagat OC team, and they are been doing overclocking for years. I mean, Lucky Noob is one of the guy that every time you see him at events, he's always smiling, whatever, even whatever, if it's tired or not, it will always be there smiling and will always help others. Will always help you out if you have an issue, and that's very important in this community. So he went back up in positive temperature.
He is currently at 5 gigahertz, so you can clearly see there's no issue running ambient. It looks like he's doing a stability check on this system because he's having some issues at lower temperatures.
All right, there's less than 4 minutes left in this second semi-final of the Overclocking World Championship, Las Vegas 2017. And this is Lucky Noob. Lucky Noob is using the same hardware than all the other guys are using. So this is composed of a Seasonic Snow Synon PSU, an Intel Core i7 7th generation core CPU, the 7700K. And they are all using that on the Gigabyte motherboard, the Z270X Gaming SoC.
3 minutes, guys.
The two overclockers are restarting the system.
Lucky Noomba here is in a rush to actually get the system all the way back down to like cold, because he did just have it ambient, so he has to pull all the way down. And Dogna is pulling it up. Apparently he crashed and is having cold boot bug issues. I guess the cold boot bug is not gone from Kaby Lake, or at least not gone on this specific motherboard, and potentially not yet gone, because I do believe this might be fixable with a BIOS update or maybe a PCB revision, as there are Skylake motherboards that don't have cold bugs or cold boot bugs at all.
And this is the choice of engineering. Sometimes you know, and sometimes you have to find out by yourself what is causing this issue. I mean, there's a good thing that all the overclockers did provide feedback to the manufacturers. I mean, this kind of competition as well allows the manufacturers to have more stable product in the end. But what they're doing here is very off limit for pretty much everyone else. So they're using liquid nitrogen to cool down the computers, and they will try to submit the last few scores before the timing run over. The person with the highest score will win that match and access the gold final here in Las Vegas in 2017. They both have to restart the system. You can see Lucky Noob is a bit worried. It's been about 10 minutes he haven't submitted a score.
Yeah, first the bronze. That would be like
getting stressed, baby.
At least.
Right, Dogna is back into the BIOS. Interesting, he didn't save like a save profile he can start from.
1 minute.
Yeah, that's losing him a lot of time.
Losing him a lot of time, and there's 50 seconds left in this game. They are trying to get the best score on 3D Mark 11 physics using the Core i7-6700K. Right now, Lucky Noob on the screen is at 5 GHz, 1.35 volts. We'll go straight to 1.55 volts.
Yep. V0 seconds right now. He even started just 1 minute, 1 second
he's
before.
He's rushing.
1.95?
Oh!
Oh, 6.4? 6.4? Yeah, 6.4. I told you, 57.
1.5. All right.
Okay, there's this. You have to launch the benchmark. The benchmark have to be launched before
now 3D
the
Mark does
countdown.
Load.
5.
Did it crash?
Four,
did it crash?
Three, 2, 1.
Did it just crash?
Over.
Oh
and
my
winner,
God!
The lucky noob again.
Woo!
Woo!
Thank you. That's fine.
Oh, and we got the blue screen!
Good guys, heat up the setup so we can recover.
All right, what a match, what a match. I mean, Lucky Noob was in front of that game for so long. I mean, he submitted the first score and then he continued on submitting the system. It's like, wow, that's quite impressive. Bizoid! I think we're gonna have a nice talk with Studios about what did happen in that game. Lucky Noob is now accessing the gold final, and he will be fighting against his previous opponents, Stepanzi. That's gonna be interesting because these two guys were actually the first two in the ranking out of the qualifier. Right after right after the break, we're gonna have the analysis with Bitzoid and Tullius, and of course that will be a nice way for us to continue on going on just up until the bronze final that will happen very quick after the analysis, and we will be able to move to the grand gold final here at the Overclocking World Championship, Las Vegas 2017. I'm Truthman from Overclocking TV, and we'll find you right after the break.